Hey, Paul, you got a nickel? I got to get something out of the soda machine. Hey, welcome to Weld.com. This is Paul Brown here. Got a question for you. What's all this change I got here and these two welding rods have in common? These are made out of nickel, and this is made out of nickel. We've been getting a lot of questions on which rod do we use, the 55 or the 99. Well, today we're going to talk about that and show you the advantages and disadvantages of both. Let's talk about compressive strength and tensile strength on cast iron, okay? We got our obligatory glove that I stole from my wife's kitchen. Compressive strength, where you're pushing in, it doesn't want to go anywhere. Tensile strength, on the other hand, you can stretch it out like this. Cast iron has very little tensile strength, but lots of compressive strength. That's what makes it so desirable to use for those parts that we were talking about, engine blocks, machine tools. The problem with cast iron is after it's poured and starts cooling down, the carbon in it turns into graphite. It precipitates out. So when you take a 7018 rod or 6010 or even a 6013, 7014, that graphite goes into the weld pool, and now the weld, instead of being a low carbon weld, becomes a high carbon weld, which it is also very brittle. And as it cools down, it loses its ductility or stretchiness. The bottom line is your weld ends up cracking, or in worst case scenarios, the joint line in the weld affected zone of the cast iron will actually crack because it's even harder than the weld pool is. Clink, clang, bang. Those are the sounds you don't want to hear as your weld is cooling if you use a mild steel rod. You want to use a nickel-based rod, or in some cases, possibly a copper-based rod like aluminum bronze. But today we're only talking about the nickel rods, 55 and 99. By using the nickel rod, they won't pick up the graphite, which causes the weld to be very hard and brittle. They stay very flexible and ductile, and so they stretch as the weld cools. How do we get a good weld on cast iron? By picking the right rod. We're gonna weld my little hand wheel off my lathe, one side with 55 and the other side with 99, and compare the difference. And do it with my old trusty Palcon inverter. You guys all did see my inverter versus transformer video, right? Well, this was the first generation from the 80s of inverters, and it looks huge compared to a lot of the modern inverters, but back in the 80s when it came out, it only weighed 80 pounds. There was two of these on every nuclear submarine in the U.S. Not necessarily this model. This is only 250 amps, but they made them in 300 and 400 amps and also 500 amps. They're rough and tough. They were dropped off ships and still worked because of this fiberglass case. And eventually the company got bought out, but the guys liked making welders so much they started another company, and they're still in business today. Great machine. This little machine will do MIG, TIG, stick, and it's even got a plasma cutter. Pretty cool for 1980s, isn't it? We're gonna turn the machine on. It's got two little breakers back here. There we go. Not that noisy. And we're gonna set it to 100 amps, which I kind of determined because I'm going by the specs of the rod manufacturer for 1/8 rod. And we're going to set it over to the stick welding setup and to the weld setup. And we're ready to go. Let's go weld some 55 rod. Okay, here's the tip of the day. I got a little piece of welding lead. I want to put that underneath my work lead there. Makes an incredible contact. Thousands of little points of electricity. Gives you a much better ground. And if your MIG starts sound like a drive-by shooting, this will correct it. See these yellow gloves? I learned a trick from my good buddy, Jason Becker. You guys know Jason Becker, right? He lives over here in Orlando with me. When you're using a die grinder that's kicking out those little stupid metal chips that get all in your leather gloves and won't come out and stab you, I'm going to put my little handy-dandy earplugs in. I hate earmuffs because they give me a headache. We're going to knock this paint off of this hand wheel from 1968. That didn't take long because basically I pre-cleaned it before you guys got here. Now we're going to take a little air die grinder, a little carbide burr, get me a little V-groove in here. Now we're ready to heat this baby up. And what I'm going to do is take an oxyacetylene torch, and we're going to get it up to about 300 degrees, which is minimum. And we're going to try to heat the whole thing and get it the same. You could use your charcoal grill. You could make an oven for it and run propane gas into it. But you need to heat the whole thing up to 350 minimum. Optimum is 5 to 9. We're going to go for 350 today. I'm going to check the temperature with this little gizmo here called a temple stick. And basically, you just put a little mark on what you're doing. And when that mark melts, you know you're up to that temperature or higher. Now, if you're too lazy to use one of those, you get you one of these $20 infrared temperature checkers. Tells you what temperature it is. Right now it says it's 76.8. And that's a quick way of doing it. So let me fire this up. And away we go. Now what you want to do is heat this real evenly. You're not trying to melt it. We're only trying to get it up to 350. My oxyacetylene flame is about 6,500 degrees. I don't know what that propane burns-o-matic is, but it's nowhere near this hot. Let's see if we can get some. Oh yeah, we're melting, baby. Look at that. I spent 5 minutes with the propane torch on that earlier and it didn't get anywhere near that hot. Look at that, 441, just like the highway that runs right by the shop here. Oh yeah, we're ready to put some metal on that. What's real important is while I'm doing this weld, I'm only doing a short weld. It shouldn't really be more than 10 times the diameter of the rod. So we've got a 1/8 inch rod, so that's what, 1 1/4 inches, no more than that. And what I want to do as soon as I stop welding is I want to peen it over with this chipping hammer that I've rounded the edge off. The other thing I can use is this needle scaler, or I can take a wire brush or a power wire brush. Both of these are power. And what that does is it actually peens it as it wire brushes. A regular scratch brush won't give you the peening effect you need. And by peening it, what we're doing is we're expanding the metal as it's trying to shrink, so it doesn't put extra stresses on the cast iron or the weld bead itself. The 55 rod we're using, we're running on DC positive with 1/8 inch rod at 85 to 110 amps. Okay, you don't want to peen it too much because you can actually work hard in the material that way. I need to put a little bit more metal on there. Basically, we're just building up a little bit at a time. One thing about nickel rod is it's real sluggish. It's almost like you're messing with bubble gum. It's nothing like 7018, 6010. You kind of have to shove it where you want it to go. So you're never going to get that stack of dimes look with either one of the rods. Let's go ahead and flip it over and try some 99 on the back. The 99 nickel rod we're using, we used a 332 rod at 70 to 85 amps. that's looking like it's getting there. I'm going to bump my amperage up just a tad. Like I said, you don't want to get the amperage way high to flatten it out. It's always going to be kind of ropey looking and move like bubble gum. Bazooka Joe. The weird thing about this rod is, and I hope that the camera's picking it up, there's a lot of little bubbly-like things that come off the flux, and it seems to be a lot more than a standard mild steel electrode. Now I'm going to use my wire brush on this one since we let it cool slightly, and I want to see what the difference is in the way it looks, because when you're peening it with this needle scaler, it really beats the devil out of it. I'm not hearing any cling, clanging, and banging yet, which is a good sign. That could be laid down a little smoother over here. That was where I was at about 85 amps, I believe, and I bumped it up to 90 amps on this edge right here. We got a little bit more welding to do on the 55. I'm going to hit it again, but I'm going to slightly turn it so I get a better angle. Okay, now that this thing's welded and it's still good and hot, what we want to do is slowly cool it. And we can do that by firing up the barbecue grill, but if I do that, everybody in the neighborhood is going to be coming over wanting something to eat. Or we can build a little oven out of fire bricks and put a big propane weed burner in there. This is fairly small. We can also put it in a little electric oven and slowly turn the heat down. Or we can cover it with a welding blanket. All those things are pretty time consuming, but I found out there's a product called bentonite that they get from actually Fort Benton in Wyoming, and they've been digging it up there for years. And so what we're gonna do is cover it with bentonite. You can also use sand for this, but I didn't have any sand, but I had plenty of bentonite. You guys may know it as Tidy Cat. We just throw that sucker in there and cover it up. Hopefully the cat won't get in there and start digging around while it's hot. If it does, the cat will definitely know. And we'll come back in a couple hours and look at it. And if we hadn't heard any tink, tink, tink coming out of this bucket, we know we're good, and then we'll do an inspection on it. Well, you got to dig a little bit. All righty. Let's have a close look of it. This was the 55 side over here. The 55 rod is what we want for multi-pass welds or thick segments, and it's a little bit stronger due to about the 40% iron that's in it. The 99 side over here. If machining is needed, drilling, tapping, you want to use the 99 rod because 55 is not machinable. You can only grind it. Oh, thanks. Have a seat. Have a seat.
So since you worked so hard, I figured I'd bring you a Coke that you've been wanting all day.
Well, thank you very much.
Yeah, I figured it'd help you out a little bit there.
Go ahead. I'm having a sip.
Thanks for watching today. If you have comments or questions, connect with us at weld.com/forum. If you want to check out exclusive content and member perks, join our channel and support the weld.com community.
See you on the next one.